Hello, I'm Dr. Akshay Mehta, cardiologist from Mumbai, India, and I would like to talk to you about the proven natural ways of reducing blood pressure. This is important for multiple reasons. Number one, it can help you prevent having hypertension if you already do not have it. Secondly, if you have mild degree of hypertension, it can be treated without the use of drugs if you follow these natural methods. Thirdly, if you have higher levels of blood pressure, like moderately severe or severe hypertension, then the number of pills that you may need may come down if you use these natural methods. Number four, because these methods impact the fundamental causation of hypertension, because they work at a fundamental level, and also they reduce blood sugar, blood cholesterol, obesity, along with blood pressure. These methods can reduce the complications of hypertension, such as stroke, heart attacks, and kidney disease. Hence, these natural methods are a cornerstone of therapy and must be used if you have hypertension. Now, one word about the use of drugs. Although these methods can reduce the number of drugs that you need, if you need drugs, you must take them. If your blood pressure does not come down with these natural methods, then you may need drugs under the supervision of a doctor, and you must take them. Modern blood pressure drugs are quite good, effective, and they can be taken for a long time, even lifelong, without losing their efficacy and without serious side effects. If at all side effects occur, they can be managed very easily by consulting your doctor. Hence, if drugs are required, please do take them. So, natural methods and drugs can work side by side and be very effective to bring your blood pressure to the optimum level of below 130 by 80. Now, what are these natural methods? Number one is weight reduction. Every 1 kilo of weight reduction reduces your blood pressure by 1 millimeter. So, if you are overweight, then please see that you can reduce blood pressure and reduce your blood pressure by reducing your weight. Second thing is sodium. Sodium is most commonly found in salt, and reducing your sodium intake or salt intake will reduce your blood pressure. Now, all kinds of salt have sodium. Common salt, the Himalayan salt, or rock salt, or sea salt, even Sindalu Namak, which is available in India, all have sodium. Sodium is also found in the soda that is used in cooking. So, always, and it is mostly most commonly found in packaged food products. So, always see the food labels and see the sodium content. Ideally, the amount of sodium should be 1 teaspoon of salt for the whole day. Now, in the market, you also get certain low sodium salts in which certain proportion of sodium is replaced by potassium, and they are quite useful to a certain extent. However, there is one warning that I would like to give, that if you are on blood pressure lowering pills, which some of them which conserve potassium in the body, if this salt substitutes or low sodium salts are taken along with these kind of pills, then your potassium levels can go up, and that could be a little dangerous. So it is better that if you are on such pills and want to take such low sodium salts, please consult your doctor before doing that. The third thing is, after weight reduction and sodium restriction, is increasing the potassium content of your food. And that is done by increasing the number of fruits, at least 3 or 4 fruits a day, and lots of green and multicolored vegetables, at least 2 bowls of vegetables in a day, and 3 or 4 fruits a day. This will be useful to reduce blood pressure. Again, a word of warning that if you are a kidney patient and you need to keep your potassium under check, then please consult a nephrologist or your physician before venturing into high potassium food. So otherwise, if you don't have kidney disease, then it is very beneficial to have at least 3 or 4 fruits a day and 2 bowls of fresh vegetables, raw vegetables. The fourth thing is about what is known as a DASH diet, dietary approaches to stop hypertension, in which besides fruits and vegetables, the emphasis is on whole grains and on a low fat milk products. So DASH diet also can reduce blood pressure. Fifth is exercise. There are 2 kinds of exercise that are useful for reducing blood pressure. One is the aerobic exercise, in which there is a lot of movement, like brisk walk, jog, swim, run, cycling, etc. At least 30 minutes every day, 7 days a week. The second type of exercise is strength training or muscle building exercises, which also should be done at least 3 or 4 times a week. And when it is done, please see that your breathing is normal at that time. So these 2 types of exercises are useful for reducing your blood pressure. Finally, alcohol restriction also is helpful for reducing blood pressure. If at all you want to have alcohol, I would advise to have it on weekends and just to 1 or 2 drinks, that's all. Because if you have drinks every day, more than 1 or 2 drinks, then your blood pressure can remain high. Sleep is an important factor in reducing blood pressure. If you don't sleep well, your blood pressure can remain high. If you are a heavy snorer, then see that you don't have, just do a checkup for sleep apnea. Because if you have sleep apnea, in which there is intermittent stoppage of breathing in your sleep, then also your blood pressure can go up, and the treatment of that will reduce your blood pressure. So the interesting thing is that each and every parameter that we discussed, or each and every method which we discussed, whether it is weight reduction, salt restriction, increasing potassium, exercise, DASH diet, restricting alcohol, each of them will reduce your blood pressure by 5 to 10 millimeters. So imagine that if you simultaneously adopt all the natural methods together, then what an impact it would cause on your blood pressure. The additional effects can be found with meditation, yoga, and breathing techniques, which can also reduce blood pressure. Now, there is another method which can reduce blood pressure, but which is a slightly controversial method, is ketogenic diet, in which the carbohydrate content is reduced to less than 30% of or 20% of total calories. That means most of your calories come from fats and proteins. Now, this diet can definitely reduce your blood pressure, can reduce your weight, triglycerides, and sugar. However, there are certain drawbacks, and the biggest drawback is that it can raise your LDL cholesterol, it can raise your chances of having cardiovascular disease. And a study has been done, which has over 15,000 patients for 25 years, in which they found a U-shaped relationship between your carbohydrate intake and mortality. If your carbohydrate intake was more than 80% of total calories, the mortality increased. On the reverse, if it was less than 30% of total calories, then also the mortality increased much more. So carbohydrate intake should be balanced to about 50 to 60% of total calories. And that too by having complex carbohydrates like whole grains, fruits, vegetables, etc. and not sugar or refined carbohydrates. So ketogenic diet is helpful, but before you venture into it, please consult your doctor and understand its advantages and disadvantages. Then of course there are other methods like flax seeds, garlic, which have not been proven, but one can have them because they don't have any harm. So these are the natural methods of reducing your blood pressure. As far as possible, you should follow them lifelong, because the more you stick to them, the better impact will be on your blood pressure and the lesser chances will be of developing complications in future. If you have any questions, you can please post me, and I would also urge you to read this book of mine called Romancing the Heart. You can Google it or write on Amazon.in and you can get it. It's romancing the heart. It answers all questions about understanding, preventing, reversing, and healing coronary heart disease and hypertension. And you can obtain it. So thank you very much. It has been a pleasure talking to you, and I hope you find this useful for your health. Thank you.